On the 21st of February 2014, members of the South Australian Air League linked up with the International Space Station for a chat. The 9-minute window was shared among many of the students, who all got to ask one question each of the astronaut. The cadets have all been building up to this for some time, and there has been much excitement now that the day is finally here.
When an astronaut gets ill, over.
This is Nicole Dory. Other than family, what do you miss most? Over.
This is Matthew Gale. Why did you decide to become an astronaut? Over.
This is Angel and George. What is the biggest challenge you have gone through on the ISS?
This is Jack Lillia. When you get back to Earth, how long does it take to recover? Over.
This is Brian Simpson. What jobs do you do in space? Over.
Hi, this is Tim. What is the weirdest physical effect you have experienced? Over.
Hi, this is Regina. Do you see satellites going past the space station? Over.
Hi, this is Matthew. What do you do to stop contagious diseases in space? Over.
We're down at the South Australian Aviation Museum with Squadron Captain Martin Ball. Martin, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Now, your cadets have done something very interesting tonight. Can you tell me a bit about it, please?
Absolutely, David. Yeah. We have. We've just spoken to one of the astronauts on the International Space Station. We've been planning this for about 12 months now. We have made an application to NASA, and that was considered by them after a proposal we put forward. And it's led up to tonight, and we've had 20 cadets ask questions to the Japanese astronaut on the space station.
And what sort of setup has gone into this? Has it been in conjunction with other radio operators or directly through NASA? Can you just tell us a bit about what's happened?
There's a voluntary organisation called ARIS, which actually has organised all the radio hookups. So where we started was choosing the questions, and the cadets would ask the questions. We've spoken with Tony here, who's the NASA representative, and then that's gone on relay to Hawaii, and they've linked to the ISS above Hawaii this evening. So we've had about four people in the chain until we got to the astronaut.
And this is a first for a South Australian unit?
Absolutely the first for the Air League in Australia.
Oh, right. Okay.
So the first time ever we've done that. And we've had a terrific evening. It's been fantastic.
And we noticed you had all the special guests here. I think the Governor was here.
We had the Governor of South Australia, Rear Admiral Kevin Scarce here, and his wife, Mrs. Scarce. And also we had our Commissioner, Tom Short, who was representing our Chief Commissioner here.
Now, the students, obviously very excited about this. What was your lead-up like in the weeks before? Like, what actually happened when you found out this was going ahead?
Well, we've been preparing for this for about 6 months now. We were pretty sure we were going to get chosen. We've been following the space station on video, basically. So we download videos off YouTube. We follow the Mars Curiosity rover, and we play those to the cadets each week so we can see what the astronauts are doing, what experiments they're doing, resupply missions and things like that. So we've been working up to it really nicely.
And the cadets have sort of, the anticipation's been building?
It's building, absolutely building. And I was really happy. Some of the cadets were a little bit nervous, but they did fine. And they spoke really clearly on the radio, which is great.
With that, I believe there's only a very short window that you had because of the way the space station travels.
That's right.
And the receiving transmitter, I think you only had about 9 minutes.
Nine and a half minutes was the window we had, and we had to get 20 cadets through, and we did, and we got them all through with a minute to spare. Yeah. So it was really exceptional, really remarkable.
Well, mate, this has been a great thing for the Australian Air League.
Oh, absolutely.
And it's good to see it went to South Australia.
Yep.
And we look forward to talking more about this in an Aviation Now episode later on.
Oh, fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Good day, David. Thank you.
Bye-bye.